Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a story time about this crazy experience I recently just had. But before we start, I want to give a little shout out to Firmu Eyeglasses Company. This video is sponsored by them, and I want to show you guys the eyeglass that I received from them. So I received these very, very cute shades. Sorry guys. Okay. So I received these very cute eyeglasses from them. These are so cute. It's so funny because I've been looking to buy some new glasses because my glasses were currently broken and still are, but I've been really looking for glasses, and when this company contacted me saying that they wanted me to review on their glasses, I was more than thrilled and more than excited and blessed. So when you first get the glasses, they will be in this little box that says Firmu on it. Yeah, Firmu, and it says their website, and your glasses will be in here. And also in here is where you can put your glasses in. Isn't this so cute? Oh, look, they got you guys like little wires, the little screws to fix your glasses if they break, which my other glasses did not have, and I got them from a different company. So you want to tighten your glasses up if they got messed up. My opinion on this company is that they were beautiful, A1, perfect. Shipping was so fast. Customer service was excellent. They responded to my questions within 24 hours. It was amazing. You don't get to see that from a lot of companies, so that was well worth it. So if you guys want to purchase my first glass that I have particularly right now, I will link it down below. And also, if you guys want to purchase one pair and get another pair free, I will link that down below as well for our promo code. So let's just get straight into the video. Let me take my glasses off because I'm ready to go in to this video. I really love these glasses. I've worn these every day. Like, with buns, these glasses are A1, D1. So, hey guys! Welcome back to my channel once again. So, we are going to get into this story time. I have not done a story time since, I don't know, what was it, like February or something? People found it really funny, you know? I don't really get that much feedback, like, on comments, which y'all should comment without telling me in person. Comment. But I got a lot of like positive feedback on the video saying how funny it was and how like they were dying watching it. So I want to give you guys another story time. So this situation just happened a week and a half ago. And girl, let me tell you, this situation pissed me off. So last Saturday, the day I attended Black Girls Rock, I'll be giving a full Black Girls Rock experience in one of my next videos. I'll have to see, but it was a great time. So I went shopping the day of. Yes, I'm very last minute to go buy clothes. To buy an outfit for that night and, you know, to just get some things here and there. So I bought my outfit. It's on Instagram. If y'all want to follow me on Instagram, my link is down below. It was like a little black and white checkered top and checkered skirt, and it was super duper cute. I was with my sister, my cousin, and my god sister, and we were at the mall, and that's where I got my outfit. I got it from Windsor. So after we went to Windsor, we decided that we wanted to get lashes. So the first time we entered the store, like my god sister, she was like looking at foundations, and you know how like you test out foundation on the back of your hand when you're not technically supposed to, but you do it anyway, like, you know, that's what girls do. So you're supposed to be secretive about it. My god sister Jordan was very secretive about it, so, you know, she was pouring on her hand, and, you know, she got caught. She didn't really get caught. I mean, I'll say caught. She didn't necessarily know it was like a big deal, because she does it all the time at other stores, like most girls do. But the lady was like, oh, you can't do that. Like, you know, we will apply it for you, and, you know, you accept it out. Like, we'll use a tester. She's like, okay, good. So that was all good. Young money, cash money, billionaires. Like, it was good. So later on, you know, we did realize that one of the ladies, it was like a Spanish-owned store, and there was a lot of other Spanish women in the store, and we were like kind of getting, we're the only black girls there, and we're like getting like followed around. You know, I don't really think anything of it because I never experienced like racial issues like before, so I didn't think anything of it. I was like, you know, maybe she's just trying to see if we need help with anything. It wasn't the same way that I was telling my gosh about the foundation. She was really nice, sweet. She was like, oh no, you can't do that, blah blah blah, and third, she was cool. It was another lady. So I didn't think anything of it. Me and my cousin are in one aisle. Then my god sister and my sister are in another aisle. So me and my cousin are looking at lashes. She's looking for lashes for her, and I'm looking for lashes for me. I didn't know if I was going to buy lashes yet. I was indecisive. So while we're there, the lady that I told you guys was like following us around the store comes up to us and like says, let me see your bag. And I'm like, okay. So I'm just handing it to her. I don't think anything of it. You know, like I said before, I've never been through like racial profile. I've never been through a situation like, you know, where I was like, oh, this girl's being racist, this girl's being racist. Like, I never had that situation happen to me. I hand her my bag and she starts stapling it. Like, it's like my bag from Windsor, because I got an outfit from Windsor before, and then went to this makeup store after. And she starts stapling my bag, and I'm like, okay, why are you stapling my bag? And then I realized she goes to my sister, who was in the opposite aisle, and she starts stapling her bag. And I'm like, okay, wait, I'm looking around like, is anybody else's bag stapled here? Like, I don't see nobody else's bag stapled. I see my bag stapled, my sister's bag stapled. We happened, I'm starting to look around, I'm like, okay, let's see, maybe, like, what's going, why are both of our bags being stapled? I'm like, let's see, we're not the only women in here. We aren't the only guys in here. We're not guys, you know what I mean? But we just so happen to be the only black girls in here. So I'm like, is this female, like, trying to, you know, be a little cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs or racist? So I go to my sister, I'm like, unstaple your bag. I unstapled my bag because I was like, you're not about to stapled my bag. She didn't see me staple it at first. Unstaple it. I was like, she's not finna, oh my god, I sound so hood. She's not about to unstaple my bag. Staple my bag. So I unstapled it. So I'm like, no, like, I don't see anybody else's bag stapled, so I'm not stapling my bag. So then my sister, and she's like, you know, just looking cool. You know, lady stapling her bag. I was like, Tanya, unstaple your bag. This is like after the lady left. And she's like, why? You know, she's being all clueless. I'm like, girl, you don't see that this lady is only stapling our bags? Like, unstaple your bag. So my sister, she starts unstapling her bag all loud, and the lady starts, she's like, oh, you need to be stapling your bag. Oh my god, I sound racist. Let me not say her voice like that. You know what? I don't care. I don't like her, so I'm gonna say it like that. She said, you need to staple your bag right back up unless you have to get out. And I'm like, what are you stapling our bags for? I don't see stapling anybody else's bag in the store. And she's not responding. She's just like, oh, you need to staple your bag. You need to get out. And then I was like, when I said to her, I was like, you're being racist right now, because I don't see stapling anybody else's bag in the store. She's like, it's not racist. I'm like, oh, it's not racist, really? Then she tells us to get out. I'm like, okay, you know what? I'm leaving them, because you don't deserve my money. I'm not about to give you my money. Like, you're bugging. So we leave, and then, so while we leave, we're out, like, we walk like three stores down. My sister wants to go back because she liked the lash that she picked out. I'm like, Ty, she does not deserve our money. I'm not about to give her my money. Some darn lashes, like, it's not worth it. And she's like, no, like, I really want those lashes. I've been looking for them, blah, blah. She's like, I'm not concerned to go and buy lashes. Like, I wanted her to know that what she did wasn't right. I'm like, if I go back in that store, I'm gonna be fighting somebody, because I just don't tolerate racism for no reason. You're not, like, I don't tolerate that. So I'm like, no, like, I don't tolerate that. And if I go back in that store, I'm gonna knock her out. Like, and I don't even fight. That's the thing. I never got in a fight before, but, like, I was pissed. Like, I don't like people that are, like, racially profiling somebody when you're a minority too. And to think about it, like, y'all more at the bottom of the spectrum than us, because people, like, Trump's treating Mexicans, Hispanics, like scums. Like, you know, he treats all minorities like scums, but especially Hispanics, he's very vocal about. But right next to me, sis, like, you ain't above me. Like, don't, bye. So we go back in the store, which my sister and my gossip back in the store. I told my cousin to wait with me. I'm like, just wait here with me, because let them handle it. So my sister's in the store, and I see the ladies, like, she talked to the lady that was, like, being rude and racist. And the lady was, like, she's giving a lot of attitude. And I'm like, who's she giving attitude to? Like, and my sister and my guys are being mad calm. So I go in the store, and I'm like, where's the manager? Talk to the lady that was being rude. I was like, I want to see the manager. And the manager, she's like, oh, she's right over there. Give me that attitude. I was like, okay, thank you. I went to the manager, and I spoke to her. And then she's like, oh, I'm so sorry about your experience, this, that, and the third. Like, you know, it's just that we have to save the bags because we've had recent issues with stealing and people stealing things. And I was like, you see how you're explaining it right now? And she's like, yeah. And I said, she didn't explain like that. She's just coming up stapling bags with attitudes. I'm like, if she's explained the way you did, there wouldn't be any issues. And if I saw a sign out in front of the store saying we staple bags because so-and-so, there wouldn't be an issue. You need to have proper signage and explain to me why you're doing certain things so I understand. I won't have an attitude next time or be upset and be like, why are you doing this? But, and I also said to the manager, I said, okay, I understand that, but I didn't see her staple anybody else's bag but ours. And we happen to be the only black girls in here. So what does that make you think? So while I'm there, my god sister and my sister are still talking. So I leave the manager. I say, okay, thank you so much. So they're still arguing with her. Not really arguing, she's arguing with them. And she's being rude. So I walk up to her. I'm like, and I overheard the conversation. I don't know what the last part they said was. I basically said to them, I was like, yeah, but you were being, I said, you were not explaining to us what you were doing. And she said, don't be smart with me. I'm like, this, oh my god. My god sister was like, you are not going to talk to, you're not, my god sister was like, you're not going to be talking to her like that. Like, who are you talking to? Like, watch your mouth. Then the lady says in Spanish, I don't speak Spanish, my god sister does. She says, these little black girls are in here starting trouble. If we, hold up. Like, if you so-called weren't being racist, why would you have to say these little black girls? Like, if you haven't realized that the racism comes, like, when someone says, like, the race specifically. Like, you could just say these little girls, which is still rude because we're clearly older. But you're saying these little black girls. So my cousin went off. She speaks Spanish. She's black like the rest, but she speaks Spanish. And she went off. It was the funniest situation ever. She was like, oh my god, I don't want to, like, mock, like, the Spanish language. But, like, because I don't, you know. But I'm supposed to do it, all right? I'm not being racist. I'm not mocking. Like, just listen. She was like, So lady said something to the manager in Spanish, like blah 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 blah. Okay. And then my cousin's like, she's like, oh, and I speak Spanish too. And she started going in. Like she's like, go. It was the funny situation ever. The lady was shook. Like she, it was so funny. She was like sitting there. She was like, oh, I know you speak Spanish. Like, no, you didn't. You thought we were some black girls. Like, y'all always want to be slick with the mouth. I'm like, oh, so then after that, everybody want to talk English. Oh, so y'all all want to talk English now when you see that we could speak, like, well, not we. She could speak Spanish. That's really, really funny. After that, we got our lashes and everything. She was dead on quiet. She was quiet as hell. And it's funny because she knew she was wrong. She was being racist. She was racially profiling. She don't want to admit it, but she knows that she was. And that's why she got so quiet. So as she's checking out our stuff, we're talking. I'm like, girl, like, in a few years, like, I'm saying, like, to my... got my sister, so she could, I didn't care if she heard or not, but it's just so she could hear. I'm like, she's like racially profiling me. You're working at a retail store, and there's nothing wrong with working at retail stores, but if you're gonna be disrespectful, then here, you're gonna get it like this. You're working at a retail store at like 50 something years old. I have aspirations and dreams going for me. I'm going to college. I'm gonna be in my education. I'm be able to buy this store in a few years. Like, don't ever play yourself by trying to degrade me because I'm a black girl. First of all, black girl power. That's why I'm so happy I went to Black Girls Rock that night, because I was so empowered. I'm like, these people will be trying me. And it's just so crazy because I went to this event, this conference called Black Girls Lead for a week, like that week before. And like, it was like funny how much these people really racially profile. And it felt so good being around so many black women. And like, it just was so empowering that I'm woke. That's why I knew right away she was being racist. Because I'm like, I'm woke right now because I've been to all these organizations with Black Girl Magic and all that. So I was woke. Like, I knew what was going on. So the end day, I got my purchase. That was a Black Girls Rock. So, yeah, that's basically the end of the story. She was shook and quiet because she didn't know my cousin spoke Spanish. And she wanted to be racist. But you cannot hate racist Black Girl Magic, Black Girls Rock, Black Girls Take Over, Bobo. And yeah, I'm not against any Spanish people. Like, girl, this, and that's another thing. Spanish people, you guys are black too. I'm sorry, because once we leave, y'all next, so stop. Like, I hate those girls. Like, I'm not black. Like, you act like black is a bad thing, but y'all want to do everything that is black. Yeah, okay. So that's the end of this video. Don't forget to share this video, like, comment, subscribe. Tell me some experiences y'all had of being racially profiled or somebody being racist towards you. I would love to read those. And yeah, I guess I will see you guys in my next video. Give me some video ideas, comments on video ideas that I should do. Video ideas. I talk so fast. Oh my god. Video ideas I should do in the future. So I love you all. Bye, bye, bye. Oh, my social media is linked down below too. So I would love y'all to check that out. Love you guys. Bye. Hey guys, please click in the upper left-hand corner to subscribe. And please click in the lower right-hand corner to watch my latest video. Love you guys. Bye.